The Oscar-nominated documentary The Square tracks 2.5 years of tumult in Egypt, from Hosni Mubarak's ouster in 2011 through the 2012 end of direct military rule and the 2013 removal of elected Muslim Brotherhood President Mohamed Morsi. The film, which can't be shown publicly in Egypt, tells the tale through 6 characters who met in Tahrir Square, especially Ahmed Hassan, a poor young secular revolutionary, and Magdi Ashour, a Muslim Brotherhood father of 4. We sat down with director Jehane Noujaim and producer Karim Amer in Washington.
So Jehane Noujaim and Karim Amer, thank you so much and congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So when this uprising against Mubarak started in early 2011, what did you see in that moment that just impelled you to rush to the square and start filming?
It was a magical moment, and this is why I make films, because I see people that inspire me, surprise me, take me to a place I've never been before, and I want to share them with the world immediately. And, I mean, we grew up in an Egypt where people were afraid to talk about how they felt about politics for fear of repercussion. But here you had men, women, people of all different classes talking about and sharing dreams of the future for the very first time.
And Karim, what is it that attracted you all, particularly to two of your main characters, Ahmed Hassan and Magdi, the young revolutionary and Muslim Brotherhood?
Well, you know, when I went down originally, I went down actually as a skeptic. But when you meet people like Ahmed, who is so representative of so many young Egyptians who had lived all their lives feeling like their story had already been written for them, that they had no sense of empowerment, they had no sense of authorship for their future, and to feel that for the first time they could pen that future, that they could build the country of their dreams, was an unbelievable feeling. You know, when you're making a film like this, that's a verite film, you don't know what's going to pan out. So their actions actually in the events is what ended up making them the characters. You know, so it was Magdi in when the Battle of Muhammad Mahmud, which is one of the kind of main scenes you see in the film, where the Brotherhood did not participate, and Magdi went against Brotherhood orders and joined the protest movement.
And he said, I'm staying
and
here.
He said, I'm staying here. That moment made him much more compelling as a character, because all of a sudden he became someone who was conflicted between two sides.
I have to say, at the end of the movie, I was left with a feeling of sadness, because the characters got on this sort of endless loop of unity and solidarity and expectation, and they would topple a ruler only to make room for the next despot. And then they'd be angry, and then they'd rail, and they'd say, well, we're going back to the streets. But it didn't really get better.
I actually am left with a feeling of optimism, and I'll tell you why. Even though we're in this very dark time in Egypt, and there are people being arrested, we have friends of ours in jail now, it's one of the worst times for journalists. People on the ground, all of the characters, will say, we've had to go through these mistakes. We had to go through the Muslim Brotherhood, for example, and the pendulum has swung the complete other direction now towards the military, right? And ultimately, I feel and I hope, and this is what our characters feel, that we'll get to a point where we'll be able to have a healthy country. I mean, I feel like it's the civil rights movement of our time, and our characters are still on the front lines struggling for it.
We as a society in Egypt and the characters we felt all had to kind of free ourselves from this fairy tale story of change, that in 18 days people can go down for the first time in their lives, do the unbelievable, topple the dictator, and then democracy is just going to flourish. And I think that we suffered from a problem that a lot of people around the world actually are trapped in, which is this kind of story of change that we're told, which is more like change's greatest hits, where we see kind of like the highlights of change throughout history. So we see Gandhi liberating India, and we see Mandela ending apartheid, and we see Martin Luther King saying, I have a dream. But we're not willing to spend 20 years in jail with Mandela when he's hopeless and no one believes in him. And what keeps me optimistic is that people like Ahmed and others in that square are no longer going to be trapped, are unwilling to go back to the old narrative, the old story of Egypt.
Yet doesn't the success also depend on this generation of revolutionaries being willing to go the next step and do that hard, gritty work of building political parties, running for office?
this was a time when we didn't have a judiciary. We didn't have a freedom of press. We didn't have these pillars of democracy. Democracy is not only the ballot box. Right. We didn't have the, and so people felt like their only way of reaching people was the streets. And I think that's where they felt their role was at that time.
And, you know, for us as filmmakers, the climax happens in the first 2 minutes. The dictator fell. Where are you going to go from there, you know? So I think that there is a lot of activity happening in Egypt. It may not all be manifesting itself into the political continuum, but there's a lot of other spaces that are helping shape the future.
Which do you think is stronger, the kind of bonds that your characters forge or this polarization that's taking place right now?
You have families that are, you know, partly brotherhood, partly pro-army, but you're exactly right. There are deep political divisions in the country today, and that is why releasing a film like this, which shows the love and brotherhood of people from opposite sides of the political divide, has been so powerful.
Do you think your characters have another chapter left in them that is more than protesting, more than returning to the square?
Oh, I do. If you talk to any one of them, they say that, first of all, there's a third wave coming. And secondly, you're talking about a new generation that has grown up for the first time with these ideas of questioning, of protesting, of the idea that there could be something different besides this binary that we've always lived in of the military on one side and the brotherhood on another side. The fact that that young people have grown up with these new ideas, and that's what we have to look for leadership in the future. So I'm deeply optimistic about that, despite the difficulties that we're going through.
And it's
now
a dedicated few. I mean, I think that is all of Egypt willing to continue the fight? No, most people are exhausted. But it's a dedicated few who stick to it and who keep getting up after every time they get pushed down, and are unwilling to relinquish that right that they feel for the authorship of their future. And I think that that's the only way that great changes ever happen. And that dedicated few can once in a while inspire the majority, as we see. And that's the power of the square.
Jehane and Karim, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having us. Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you so much.